Welcome to ECT Laboratory. Today video is about how to write very long HTML module for priority encoder using model SIM. Priority encoder. The function of digital encoder is complementary to that of a digital decoder. High encoder active a specified output for a unique digital input code. An encoder operate in the reverse direction, producing a particular digital code like binary or BCD number and its output when a specific input is active. Priority encoder. One solution of this problem is to assign priority level at each input, and if two or more are active, make the output code correspond to the highly priority input. This is called a priority encoder. Highest priority is assigned to the input whose subscription has the logical value. For writing the Verilog module, now I am going to our model SIM software. To start modeling, goes to the model SIM shortcut. Now I am in model SIM, goes to file to new to project, press yes to continue. Name, so type project name is encoder, press OK. Now create new file, type file name encoder 1, add file type as Verilog, so press OK, then close. So you can see our encoder file is created. This type is Verilog. Now right click here and press edit. Now here is our edit window. For the sake of time saving, I already write Verilog HTL module for priority encoder in Notepad. So here our priority encoder module in Verilog. So now I right click here and copy this code. Now comes to our edit window and right click here and paste our Verilog HDL priority encoder module. So in first line I type module V Verilog underscore priority encoder 1 and input cell and code is output. In second line I define input cell as 8 bits 0 to 7. In third line I type output code 2 to 3. In third line I type code output as 3 bit register code. Then always at cell, so you can see cell in bracket, then begin. Now in this video I use if else command. So first line if, and our input is 0 in decimal, then our code is 000 come at output code. Then in second case, else if cell is equal to 1 in decimal, then output of encoder is 001 in binary. In third case, if input is cell 2 in decimal, then output of encoder is 010 in binary. In fourth case, if cell input in decimal is 3, then the output of encoder is 011. In fifth case, if input SEL is equal to 4 in decimal, then the output code of binary is 100. In sixth case, if cell input is equal to 5 in decimal, then the output in binary is 101 in 3 bits. In seventh case, if cell input is equal to 6 in decimal, then the output of code in binary is 110. In eighth case, if SEL input is 7 in decimal, then the output of in binary is 1, 1, and 1. If the cell is equal to any undefined value or other than these values, then the code, and then the output of binary is equal to XXX, and then end module, and then end the bean statement, and at the last line I type end module that start here and press enter. Now we check our Verilog module by compiling this file. First I save by pressing save button, and then here our encoder file, right click here, comes to compile, and compile selected. So after that you can see compile of encoder 1.v pass successful. Now our priority encoder module in Verilog HDL is correct. After the compilation of our module, now I am going to simulate its results. So for simulation, library to work, here is our file to p priority encoder 1. So here is our module, and double click on this module. So now comes to add 2-wave to all items in region. So add wave same. Now comes to wave window, and you can see here are the 0 to 7 inputs and 0 to 2 outputs. So you can see the output by clicking on the run button. So you can see there are the outputs, inputs value, and this is the output value of encoder. Every time when I press the run button, 100 nanosecond waves comes. You can change the run length by here two arrows. So you can make it 100, 50, 200 as you want, as you wish. Now I am signing out by promising to meet you again very soon with another video. Till then, if you are watching on YouTube, please do not forget to hit like button and share my video. Thank you.